Hi guys, welcome to my channel Cooking Diaries. Today I'm going to show you how to make Bûche de Noël. That's right, a classic French dessert, a chocolate Yule log cake that's made during holidays. It may look complicated, but do not worry at all. With a little bit of patience and this recipe, you'll be able to make this beautiful Yule log cake, and it is sure going to be a star on your dining table. So let's get started. We're going to make a sponge cake sheet. For that, we would need 5 eggs, 2/3 cup of sugar, half a cup of cocoa powder, a good quality unsweetened one, 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, half a teaspoon of salt, and some vanilla. For our filling, we are going to make a quick buttercream. Here I have 1 2/3 cup of powdered sugar or confectioner sugar, half a cup or 1 stick of unsalted butter, 1.5 tablespoon of cocoa powder, again unsweetened, a good quality one, 2 tablespoons of coffee, and 2 tablespoons of cream cheese. You could also use mascarpone cheese instead of cream cheese. And for our ganache, we would use 8 ounces of chocolate. You could use a chocolate of your choice, sweet, dark chocolate, milk chocolate, whatever you prefer, and 1 cup of heavy cream. I'm using my stand mixer with whisk attachment. You could do this by hand or you could use electric hand mixer as well. So first I'm going to crack all of my eggs open into the bowl. To this I'm going to add my sugar, about half a teaspoon of vanilla, and now I'm going to whisk these eggs until they are like pale in color, nice and fluffy. They almost double in the volume. I'll show you guys once they are there and ready. Alright, our eggs are nicely whipped, our sugar is all mixed in. So you need to keep on mixing our eggs until they look something like this. The best way to tell if they're ready or not is basically you lift this and you could try number 8 like that. I'll show it again. See that? So once you are at that stage, your eggs are ready. So now we are going to sift all of our dry ingredients into this. My cocoa powder, my all-purpose flour, and salt. Now we are going to finish this by mixing it with a spatula. We don't want to lose all of that air that's whipped into that eggs. So we are going to mix it just until the wet and dry are combined. Here I have 13 by 18 baking sheet, guys. I sprayed some cooking spray and put my parchment paper on. And it's very important that we grease the parchment paper as well. So I sprayed more cooking spray on top of it. The reason is our cake batter doesn't have any fat in it except the eggs, but we did not add any butter or oil. So if we don't grease the parchment paper, the cake is going to stick to this and it's not going to be pretty. So it's very important that you grease this parchment paper as well. Now pour the batter in. We are going to use every single drop of the batter. We are not going to lose anything. I think of sponge cakes as if like they are giant omelets, because if you look at them, I mean, all they have is eggs with some flavoring, very little flour. Now try to spread this through the pan. Don't worry guys, it is going to look like super thin batter, and it is a very thin batter, but it is going to bake for very little time. Once we have the batter into the pan fairly even, pick up your pan and tap it few times onto the countertop so that we get rid of some of those big air bubbles that are there. Now this is going to bake at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for about 8 to 10 minutes. It would get a slight color on top, and you would know it when you touch it. It should be springing back fairly easily. While the cake is getting baked, take a clean kitchen towel and dust it generously with powdered sugar. Once the cake is out of the oven, we are going to take the cake while it is still warm and put it onto a kitchen towel and wrap it so that it would be rolled into a nice roll shape. And while it cools down, it would retain that shape that would help us when we later add our filling in and roll it up. So it kind of have this as a memory into it while it cools down, that it has to roll up into a nice roll. My cake just came out of the oven, guys. So I'm going to let the pan stand at one corner of this kitchen towel and gently flip it. Now slowly lift the pan. This is why it is very important to grease our parchment paper. As you can see, it's very thin layer of cake that's nice and spongy. It's perfect. So now I'm going to turn the kitchen towel and start to roll it from one end with kitchen towel inside it. Yeah, it may sound odd, but this is how we are going to do it. And try to not apply too much pressure because this is a very delicate cake. So with a soft touch, try to roll as tight as you can, but don't apply too much pressure on it. Once it is all closed and done, now we are going to let this sit on our counter and cool down for about 15 to 20 minutes. While this is cooling down, we will go ahead and make our filling for this cake. Now we are going to make our buttercream filling. So basically we are going to add our soft room temperature butter into the mixer. Again, I have a whisk attachment here. You could do this by hand too. To this, I'm going to add my cream cheese. It helps if all of your ingredients are at room temperature. Otherwise, they will have trouble mixing in. I'll give them a head start by mixing them for 2 seconds. Now to this, we are going to add our sugar and our cocoa powder and give it a quick mix. Start on slow, otherwise your sugar is going to fly all over. Now add a couple tablespoons of coffee. Right, our buttercream is nice and soft and fluffy and ready. It's very important we whip this good because we want it to be nice and soft so that we can apply it easily inside that very delicate sponge cake that we have. All right, once the cake is cooled down a little bit, let's open it. Because of the powdered sugar that we added, it did not stick to the kitchen towel. Perfect. Now we are going to put all of our frosting on here. You can use the same spatula to spread it, but I'm going to move to my small offset spatula because it just helps to spread it easily. Try to spread the frosting evenly across the entire cake. Once it is relatively spread evenly, try to roll the cake again just like how we rolled before, this time without the towel in it, just the cake. Again, be gentle with it. Once it is rolled up, we are going to wrap it in plastic wrap. Then I'll wrap that back into the kitchen towel. Now we are going to place this in the fridge and let it set for a couple hours. Next, we are going to make a quick ganache. I'm going to add 8 ounces of chocolate to 1 cup of hot heavy cream. And I'm going to let it sit for a minute until our chocolate softens up a little bit. Then I'll give it a whisk. And just like that, we have nice and smooth ganache. It might look runny right now, but by the time our cake chills down in the fridge for a couple hours, this will also thicken up a little bit and it would become easy for us to apply this ganache on top of our cake. Let's cut a piece at an angle so that we could use it as a branch to the other side of the log. Look at that beautiful swirl. Isn't this pretty, guys? Let's take a look at our ganache that has been chilling. It has become thick now compared to how thin it was when we made it. Now this is more pliable. First, I'm going to take this piece and apply some ganache to the back of it and put it next to the cake so it looks like there is a branch coming out of the log. Apply some more ganache at the joint and add more ganache on the entire cake now. We are going to make the exterior look like a bark of a tree or log, so don't worry about making it smooth or pretty or anything like that. Just cover it with the chocolate and make sure you don't cover these ends because we do want to show off those beautiful swirls. And once it's kind of covered all over with the ganache, we'll put it back into the fridge for about 20 minutes for it to set. Alright guys, once it's chilled down in the fridge, take a fork or you can do it with the knife as well and just try to run it on the cake.
This basically gives the ridges on the log that we usually have on a dried bark or log. Once you give the ridges, try to carefully transfer this onto a platter.
It's optional, but try to decorate the cake with candied rosemaries and candied cranberries and dust it with some powdered sugar. It just gives that beautiful winter frosty look to the cake.
Alright, let's give it a taste test, guys. I'm super excited for this. It looks so good. It's nice, it's chocolatey, it's balanced and sweet. This screams holidays and enjoyment. Make this cake for your friends and family. I'm sure they would love it. Check out my playlist for all of the cakes. Give me a thumbs up and make sure to hit that subscribe button so that I will see you in another video. Until then, bye!